You and I know that the first and great commandment is to love God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And if we're going to love God that way, then we want to know what He says and we want to obey Him. Now, there are certain situations in which, just due to society, due to life, due to the way the family is structured, people are placed in positions under other people. And yet, in all those cases, if we check the scope of Scripture, if we get the entire scope of Scripture, then what we'll see is that when we are to obey other people, it is always in light of the fact that our primary obedience has to be to God. Now, if you and I are going to live a Christian life, what we want to be able to do is read the Bible and understand it and have it speak to us. And that's why a good translation of the Scripture is so important. We want to be reading a translation of the Bible that really speaks God's Word. Now, let's go to Colossians. In that light, let's go to Colossians chapter 3. We're going to start in verse 18. Colossians 3 talks about children, wives, husbands, fathers, slaves, masters. lots of different people here being addressed. So it's important that we understand what's going on and see what's happening. In Colossians 3:18, it starts wives. 3:19, husbands. 3:20, children. 3:21, fathers. 3:22, slaves. And interestingly enough, in Colossians 4:1, masters. And I, frankly, if it was up to me, I would not have broken the chapter between 3:25 and 4:1, because the return to general address is in Colossians 4:2. So I'd start and I'd probably have Colossians 4:1 have actually been Colossians 3:26. But that's a different story. Now notice what it says about wives here in Colossians 3:18. Wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. If you and I are going to understand this verse, then we have to understand the phrase in the Lord. What does the phrase in the Lord mean? Well, the phrase in the Lord, and by the way, sometimes it's in the Lord, sometimes it's in Christ, sometimes it's in Him, but with the preposition in there, in the Lord, what is happening in the Greek is it's defining a relationship. There's a relationship. Now, the exact nature of the relationship is not defined by the simple phrase in the Lord, not defined by the simple word in. The nature of the relationship has to be gleaned from the context. A good example of this would be in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 22, where we read, "For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all shall be made alive." In Adam, in Adam, we're not inside Adam. What's it mean? Again, the word in defines a relationship. In other words, in our association with Adam, that we are his physical descendants and we're born with the sin nature, in our association with Adam, we all die. In our association with Christ, we're all made alive. Sure, you get born again, you're associated with Christ, you live forever. That's pretty good. So here now we have this Colossians 3:18 that says, wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord. The next thing we need to learn about the phrase in the Lord is that oftentimes it's what we call a governing phrase. It's not adjectival or descriptive in the sense that you pick one word out of the verse and it describes that. Rather, what's happening is it's governing the whole phrase, because what it's saying is, wives, submit to your husbands as it is fitting. And you're supposed to do this in your relationship with the Lord. So when a phrase is governing like that, you can move it around however it works for you. You could say, in the Lord, wives, submit to your husbands. You could say, wives, in the Lord, submit to your husbands. You could say, wives, submit in the Lord to your husbands. Do you see what I mean? The word in the phrase in the Lord is governing. And there are other verses in which you can see this too. I'm thinking of Ephesians 5:8, which says, you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. What's that saying? in your association with the Lord, you are light. And it could read, but in the Lord, now you are light. Or, now in the Lord, you are light. You see where I'm getting at? In other words, the phrase, in the Lord, can be moved around. It's a governing phrase. Basically, what Colossians 3:18 is saying is, wives, submit to your husbands, but it's inside the relationship, your relationship with the Lord. I have run into Christian wives who do things that I would consider to be very unwise and ungodly, but who say, well, the Bible says I'm supposed to submit to my husband, so I'm doing it, even though I know it's wrong. No, we can't handle the Scripture that way. The Scripture says submit in the Lord, that there's a relationship of the Lord here. And by the way, in a 10-minute YouTube teaching, we don't have to go into Ephesians and other verses of scope which talk about mutual submission. There are aspects of the relationship in which the husband submits and this kind of thing. This particular teaching is not about the how wives are supposed to submit or whatever. What I'm trying to communicate here is that this phrase, in the Lord, is very important to understand, because God never tells us as human beings just submit to another human being no matter what they say. And so then in verse 19, husbands, says, love your wives, don't be embittered against them. No phrase in the Lord there, none needed. Because in husbands being loving, by definition, love is always in the Lord. Then verse 20, and I'm going to read out of the NET Bible, the NET Bible. He says, children, obey your parents in everything, for this is pleasing in the Lord. Interestingly enough, in the Greek text, and remember, as God had men of God write the Scripture down, Paul and Peter and James and others, and they wrote God from God breathed, it says, and Peter is the gift of Holy Spirit, carried them along. As these men wrote this way, then that Greek text was inspired. Then it's important that we translate that properly. The Greek text of both verse 18 and verse 20 end in the exact same phrase. You know, in the Lord. Both verses end in the Lord in the Greek text. And yet, the majority of the versions I checked, the English versions that I checked, didn't have that. They would do something like the ESV, Holman, NIV, even the King James said something like, for verse 20, obey your parents and everything, for this pleases the Lord. And now all of a sudden we have a phrase where what pleases the Lord? If you obey your parents in everything. That's not what God is saying. When God puts one person underneath another, there's always, from the scope of Scripture, a caveat saying that you don't obey if people are asking you to do things that are ungodly. So I think it's if we're going to be able to read the Bible and live from it, that should be something Christians can do. We should be able to pick up a Bible, trust the translators, and live from that Scripture. Okay, I've got verse 18, wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord, but it should be exactly the same for verse 20. Children, obey your parents in everything, for this is pleasing in the Lord. Again, a governing phrase. It could be children in the Lord, obey your parents. Children, obey in the Lord your parents. Children, obey your parents in the Lord. Children, obey your parents and everything in the Lord. It's a governing phrase. Once again, in general, children are to obey their parents. But if your parent runs a stealing ring and asks you to steal with him, no, you're not supposed to obey that. You know, Peter made this very clear when the governing authorities asked him to do something. And in Acts 5:29, it says, Peter and the apostles replied, we must obey God rather than people. And you and I need to be prepared to obey God rather than people. That is the message of the New Testament. So just an understanding and scope of the fact that you and I, God does in many situations put us into places where we are to submit to others. Husbands, wives, children, bosses, that kind of thing. But we always, as human beings, are to love God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, and always make sure that when we're submitting to others, it's always in the Lord, in our association with Him. God bless you.